Today I am teaching you the calibration of thermocouple. This is an instrument for the calibration. Now first I will go for J-type. First I will fix the thermocouple. Thermocouple is nothing but one where the two dissimilar metals are. Has to be placed in such a way that one should be cold, the other should be other end, the other junction should be in hot. Electromotive force will be produced. This is the RTD, resistant temperature detector. This is thermocouple. I have said it J type. Take the J type and plug it to the respective J type. Now and set the knob to the J type. I have said it J, K and T. With respect to J, you have to go for J. Rotate to the J. Now dip these two into the cold water. Dip it into cold water in a cold beaker. This is a cold beaker provided here. Dip into cold water. Cold beaker. And set. This RTD. The some problem is there. It is 26.5. There is a point is missing here. Okay. It is a 26.4. The point is missing here. Now I have to make this RTD temperature equal to the thermocouple temperature. Sorry, I have to make thermocouple temperature equal to RTD temperature with the help of mean knob. Now 26, 26. After making equal, then place in the hot beaker. Hot bath beaker, place it here and switch on. Switch on. I have made it switch on there. Switch is on. Now temperature increases. I'll go for maximum is 100, but I will go for 90 here for the experimental purpose. It should be 90. After reaching 90, we have to set the thermocouple to the 90 in order to balance the waste energy. Experiment, be careful. Safety precautions I have to take. Okay, after reaching the 90, switch off the main switch of this heater. Switch off and then balance the bridge. Let's balance the bridge. Balance the thermocouple to 91 or 90. No, 92, 92. Remove from the hot bath and dip into the cold water. Cold water. We have to wait till the RTD reaches the room temperature. Here the room temperature is nothing but we are considering the water temperature. In the water we will assume it as a room temperature. The point is missing here. It is 27.1 here. The point is missing here. Okay, it is 26.9 degree it is. Now RTT is reaching to the stable temperature. Now RTT is the stable temperature. Next, this is the important part. Now it is almost reached to the stable temperature. First, how to take the reading will is an important rule here. First, this is the thermocouple part. First, you have to dip the thermocouple part in such a way that as soon as it reaches to 26 degree, you have to dip this RTD. Then you have to take the reading simultaneously. Okay, first, I will go for thermocouple. Then I will wait for RTD. As soon as it reaches to 26, I will dip this one. Now, for 30 it is 42, 42 is 53, 51 is 58, 60 is 65, 70 is 70, 80 is 76, 485 is 80. Now these readings are enough for the further calculation. This is the simplest way of doing the thermocouple. Okay, I will go for again for K type. I will remove this one. I will go for K type. RTD is dipped into the cold water. I will go for K type here. The same procedure you have to follow. This is the K type. The K is written here. K type. Again, dip into the cold water. The procedure remains same for the K type. Now for the K type, you have to set to the knob should be set to the K. Now I have to make this thermocouple to the RTD temperature. 26. Now remove from the cold and dip into hot bath. Make it on, switch on. Because already it is hot, therefore it reaches the maximum temperature suddenly. Now it is reaching 82. I will make it 90 as a cutoff. Maximum you have to go for 100 here, but experimental safety precautions, 90 is enough. Now, as it reaches to the 90, stop. Stop this birth, hot birth container. Now you have to make thermocouple to 91 in order to balance the bridge. No, 1991. Remove from the cold container and dip into the remove from the hot container and dip into the cold container. We have to wait till it reaches to the room temperature. I will consider this room temperature as 27. No problem. Now, the procedure remains very important here. First, dips this K-type into the hot bath. As soon as the thermocouple reaches to the RTD temperature, dip the RTD and take the reading. Now everything is fine here. First, I will dip this thermocouple. I will wait till it reaches to the 26. As it reaches to the 26, I will dip this one. Now 26 for 30, 44, for 42 it is 53, for 50 it is 61, 60, 65, 70, 72. For 80, it is 79. Okay, this much readings are enough for the thermocouple. If you go 90, no problem. I think it doesn't go for 90. It is, let's stop around 88. Okay, this is the procedure to calibration of thermocouple for K type. Okay, I will again dip into the RTD. RTD always it is fixed here. Next, last one. I will go for J type. J type is already completed. K type is here. T type. I will go for T type here. Okay, respective color code. Again, place both in a cold water. Make it the temperature, thermocouple temperature to the room temperature. I will make it say for 20. Oh, before that one, I have to set to the T type. Knob has to move to the T. I have to reset the RTD temperature is 27. It will come to 26, but time is very less, therefore directly I will go for it 27. I will dip again into the hot bath, hot beaker, start, make it on. Again the procedure remains same.
maximum is 100. I will cut off for the 90. Okay, it is 90 now. I will switch off the hot bath. I will make the thermocouple to 90, 91. Around 91 I will make it in order to balance the Wheatstone bridge. Both are same. Remove from the hot beaker, dip into the cold beaker. Okay, the artery is reaching nearly 26. Okay, first, now it is already 26 near. Time is very less, therefore I will go for directly experiment. First, I will dip this thermocouple into the hot beaker. Then I will wait for, as it reaches to the 27, I will dip this one. Okay, 27. For 30 reading is 40. For 40 it is 51. For 50 it is 58, for 60 it is 65, 70, 71, for 80 it is 77. In this way, we have to carry out the calibration of thermocouple. I am Santosh Gadkar. Thank you very much.